திருக்கோளூர் பெண் பிள்ளை 30th ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் எஸ் கடித்து அவனை கண்டேனோ திருமங்கையாரை போலே ஷி ரெஃபர்ஸ் திருமங்கையாழ்வார் இன் தி ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் திருமங்கையாழ்வார் இஸ் த லாஸ்ட் ஆழ்வார் ஆஃப் 12 ஆழ்வார்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவிசம் இ வாஸ் பார்ன் இன் திருக்குறையலூர் நியர் திருவாலி இன் தமிழ்நாடு He was born in the month of Kartikei under the influence of Kritika star as a manifestation of Vishnu's Saranga Bhav. His parents named him Neela after Lord Krishna. He grew up, became a young man, learnt military arts and he joined the army of King Chola. The king appreciated him for his bravery and he gave him a part of his kingdom to take care of it. Neelan met a beautiful girl, Kumudavalli. He wanted to get married to her. He approached her. She put a condition. The condition was he should dedicate his life towards Emperuman and he should dedicate himself for doing service to Sri Vaishnava Bhaktas. He should serve food for 1008 Bhaktas every day for a year. He agreed to do all that. Then he went to Tirunarayur and approached Perumal to do Pancha Samskaram for him, five-folder sacrament. God agreed and he did it. Neelan and Kumudavalli got married. As days passed, since he spent lots of money, his wealth decreased. He could not even pay tax to his king. He started stealing and plundering jewels and plundering the wealth of people. Perumal decided to change his attitude. Perumal appeared as bridegroom. He came with Nampirati. So both bride and bridegroom, they were coming near Thirumanang Kollai in wedding kolam and Neelan stopped them and ordered them to give away all jewels. He didn't realize the couple was none other than Perumal and Thayar. So the disguised god said, "Oh, are you Kaliyan?" But he could not identify the Perumal. So he was looking only at the jewels. He got the jewels. He made them remove all the jewels and he found a ring on left on the toe of Perumal. So he asked Perumal, the disguised god, to remove that. Then God said, "Yes, you can take it." He tried and he finally tried with his teeth and extracted it by force. So when he bent down and tried to take the toe, the ring from his toe, he God took it as if he is asking for charanagati. Then Neelan tried to lift the sack in which all the jewels were kept. He could not lift it. So he asked Perumal, "Did you do any mantra? What mantra you use? Tell me, I want to take this bag." Then God said, "Yes, I will teach you that mantra. You come closer to me and lend your ear." Then this Neelan alias Kaliyan alias Thirumangai Mannan, he said, "No, I will not. Why should I bend my head to you?" And threatened with his sword, "Come on, you reveal that mantra." Then God said, "Here is the mantra. You repeat that mantra." Then Kaliyan repeated that mantra. Kaliyan was blessed with Ashtakshara mantra. When he repeated that mantra, he realized some transformation in his body and mind. He was in tears. He could recognize the disguised god now. He could feel he was Vayalali Manavalan with his Thayar has come to give him a new phase of life. With tears, he started singing a pasuram. Vaadinen vaadivarindinen manathal perunthuyar idumbayil pirandu koodinen koodi ilaivar thammodu avar tharum kalaviye karuthi oodinen oodi uivadhor porulal unarvenum perum padam therindu naadinen naadi naan kandu kondeen narayana vennum naamam. There were so many other pasurams he sang, which are under Periya Thirumozhi, Thirukkurundandakam, Thirunedundandakam, Thiruvezhukkuthirukkai, Siriya Thirumadal, Periya Thirumadal. Thirukkovalur Penpillai referred Thirumangai Azhvar's Bhagavata Kaingaryam because he bit the toe of Perumal. Then he realized and he got the grace of Perumal. So she was referring that Vairagya, Jnanam, devotion, Shraddha. And she was saying, I didn't have any of this. If I had, I would not have thought of leaving this place. She was revealing all this to Ramanujar.